Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Ken Kington.
Welcome, everyone. Welcome to the 13th Annual Classified Employee of the Year Awards. And if you're at a table with one of the classified employees, please refrain from asking them what they do because they're required to tell you, but then they'd have to kill you. So the classified employees, you know teachers, you know administrators, but this is about you today. And we are so thankful and are so appreciative for you. I'm just curious. I want to see a show of hands. How many of you actually went to school in Cobb County? Raise your hands. That's amazing. That's awesome. Well, they are lining up, and we're about ready to do this to get the awards going. And here's what's going to happen. They're actually going to receive a plaque, and they're going to get a photo, and we're going to come across, and they're going to actually be introduced in alphabetical order of schools, which means my alma mater, Argyle Elementary School, which is a stone's throw from the new Braves stadium. I don't advocate throwing rocks from the playground, but you could hit the stadium, and that'll be first, and we'll go through the whole. And then at the end, we're going to have four special awards there. So without further ado, I want to welcome and have you join me in welcoming the superintendent of Cobb County Schools, Mr. Chris Ragsdale. Come on up, Chris. I know, your first name, Chris. That was the first one. I also want you to join me in welcoming the deputy superintendent and former president of the United States, John Adams. And we are blessed to have a lot of the board members here as well. Mr. David Chastain, vice chairman, Mr. Scott Sweeney, Mr. Randy Scanamahorn, Mrs. Susan Thayer, Mr. David Morgan, Mr. David Banks, and Mr. Brad Wheeler. Please give them a hand for being here as well. Well, I want you to, I'm going to ask you to do this a couple times because this is a very special group, but I want you to give a hand to all our honorees as we now get to recognize them individually. Give them a hand.
From Ackworth Elementary School, Tehran Belu. From Addison Elementary School, Kim Edgett. From Allatoona High School, Allison Rich. From Argyle Elementary School, Carlene Creary. From Austell Elementary School, Diane Harrell. From Autry Middle School, Gloria Daniel. From Baker Elementary School, Jennifer Castro. From Barber Middle School, Stacy Hill. From Bells Ferry Elementary School, Melissa Blossom. From Belmont Hills Elementary School, Ralph Kendrick. From Big Shanty Elementary School, Marty Kinser. From Burney Elementary School, Deara Jenkins. From Blackwell Elementary School, Stephanie Rush. From Brumby Elementary School, Jack Chen. From Bryan Elementary School, Sherry Douglas. From Bullard Elementary School, Belva Adams. From Campbell High School, Bola Akubagam. From Campbell Middle School, Deborah Ford. From Chalker Elementary School, Jeanette Harrison. From Cheatham Hill Elementary School, Kathy Ellis. From Clarkdale Elementary School, Barbara Velez. From Clay Elementary School, Leslie Brown. From Compton Elementary School, Leslie Broom. From Cooper Middle School, Tabitha McDaniel. From Daniel Middle School, Wendy Parr. From Davis Elementary School, Glenn Creelman. From Dickerson Middle School, Wendy Linda Mulder. From Dodgen Middle School, Linda Caballero. From Dowell Elementary School, Brenda Barina Cortillo. From Due West Elementary School, Sharon Spurgeon. From Durham Middle School, Jerry Cognaten. From East Cobb Middle School, Tori Wilson. From East Side Elementary School, Penny Bedsoll. From East Valley Elementary School, Stacy Dellinger. From Fair Oaks Elementary School, Kathy Gravely. From Ford Elementary School, Amni Demian. From Fry Elementary School, Jan Anderson. From Garrett Middle School, Donella Hughes. From Garrison Mill Elementary School, Kristen Barnosky. From Green Acres Elementary School, Katherine Kearney. From Griffin Middle School, Lucia Gonzalez. From Haven at Skyview, Carolyn Pinckney. From Harmony Leland Elementary School, Chad Brown. From Harrison High School, Kim Greaves. From Hayes Elementary School, Kathy Spencer. From Hendricks Elementary School, Matthew Brooks. From Hightower Trail Middle School, Dennis Oliver. From Hillgrove High School, Dwight Randall. From From Hollydale Elementary School, Cynthia Hodgen. From Kahili Elementary School, Tracy Clower. From Cal High School, Rosa Ali. From Kemp Elementary School, Patrice Lawson. From Kennesaw Elementary School, Dorothea Groff. From Kennesaw Mountain High School, Michelle Frazier. From Kincaid Elementary School, Cindy Knight. From King Springs Elementary School, Courtney Young. From LaBelle Elementary School, Todd Flinte. From Lassiter High School, Alice Brown. From Lewis Elementary School, David Bacon. From Lindley Sixth Grade Academy, Naomi Suffront. From Lindley Middle School, Clarence Scott. From Lost Mountain Middle School, Allison Miller. From Loving Good Middle School, Rosa Runk. From Mapleton Elementary School, Laura Beth Postel. From Mabry Middle School, Carol Batchelor. From McCall Elementary School, Gail Beckman. From McCleskey Middle School, Lisa Day. From McClure Middle School, Greg Hicks. From McEachern High School, Antonio Robinson. From Milford Elementary School, Lisa Bowen. From Mountain View Elementary School, Barbara Glenn. From Mount Bethel Elementary School, Shayla Thomas. From Murdoch Elementary School, Brenda Holmquist. From Nicholson Elementary School, Kathleen Breen. From Nickajack Elementary School, Jessica Powers. From North Cobb High School, Wayne Banks. From Norton Park Elementary School, Janessa Moriera. From Osborne High School, Scott Heron. From Palmer Middle School, Angela Holtzclaw. From Pebblebrook High School, Latrice Colvin. From Pickett's Mill Elementary School, Kim Baldwin. From Pine Mountain Middle School, Teresa Bennett. From Pittner Elementary School, Elizabeth Palmer. From Pope High School, Jeannie Jankowski. From Powder Springs Elementary School, Iris Aguilar. From Powers Ferry Elementary School, Jana Ross. From Riverside Intermediate, Celerino Salvador Hernandez. From Riverside Primary School, Seba Wright. From Rocky Mountain Elementary School, Bonnie Goldsmith. From Russell Elementary School, Sonia Arroyo. From Sanders Elementary School, Lanitha Weaver. From Sedalia Park Elementary School, Deborah Ray. From Shallotford Falls Elementary School, Amy Barr. From Simpson Middle School, Brianna Smith. From Smitha Middle School, Kelly Wilbur. From Smyrna Elementary School, Joyoso Cutno. From Soap Creek Elementary School, Selena Beasley. From South Cobb High School, Takesha Farmer. From Sprayberry High School, Robert Ward. From Still Elementary School, Karen Kinzel. From Tapp Middle School, Felix Soros Quezada. From Teasley Elementary School, Cornelia Washington. From Tritt Elementary School, Stacy Colley. From Varner Elementary School, Michael Cunningham. From Walton High School, Amelia Gilvin. From Wheeler High School, Jacqueline Escott. From the Academic Division, Kelly Brown. From the Accountability Division, Natalie Feller. From the Financial Services Division, Diana Cothran. From the Fleet Maintenance Department, Eric Carroll. From the Food and Nutrition Services Department, Lori Latif. From the Human Resources Division, Michelle Rivera. From the Leadership Division, Mickey Birchman. From the Maintenance Department, Bob Straub. From the Operational Support Division, Darcy Snelling. From the Police Department, Officer James Brown. From the Technology Services Division, Sherry Hawkins. From the Transportation Department, Jody Westfall. From the Transportation Department, Kathy Berry. From the Transportation Department, Carrie Arnold. From the Transportation Department, Melissa Davis. From the Transportation Department, Diane Etheridge. From the Transportation Department, Jimmy Pierre. From the Transportation Department, James Majek Domi. And from the Transportation Department, Tracy Brock.
Y'all give all our honorees a big hand one more time, please. And at this time, I want to bring John Adams back. He's actually going to introduce the four district-wide winners this morning. So y'all give John a hand, please.
Thank you, Ken. Having been a history major as an undergrad, I can assure you I've never heard that president joke before. I have to give the mic back, though. That's the problem. It's my pleasure to announce the district-level winners. These winners were selected by a panel of administrators who were brought together to carefully review the employees' nomination information. Beginning with our elementary-level winner, we recognize a person who has a great rapport with students and always has a positive attitude. He accepts new responsibilities as opportunities to ensure the development of relationships with students and the community. His colleagues praise him for being a hard worker whose constant smile alone fosters an energetic and positive morale and school climate. His principal says that with the innovative instruction and consistent supervision of this person, students are provided with important ways to increase and maintain their wellness. Please join me in congratulating Matthew Brooks from Hendricks Elementary School. As Matthew joins us on stage, let's learn more about him from his principal, Patrick O'Connell.
He's just a generous and happy, happy person. When I walk into the school, when I see like the carpool line in the morning, he's greeting the kids, the families, and like totally sets the stage. Like he's always got a smile for everyone. He's a happy person. He's got a special way of connecting with different people in different ways. He doesn't say no very often or easily. He's just he's generous with his time, generous with a great attitude, and he really helped set a really positive culture here in our school. He's a big part of it. Matt, congratulations on being named Cobb County's Elementary Level Classified Employee of the Year.
Yes, sir. You got it. Congratulations.
Next is our middle school level winner. She served in the district at her school for 10 years as a paraprofessional. Her principal recognizes her for the incredibly positive approach to help in any way she can with new tasks and special challenges. In working with students, she's been noted for her perfect balance of fun and tough love to secure relationships and instruction. She seeks to do the right thing every time and to always be a trusted voice and dependable person for her peers and for students. Please join me in congratulating Jerry Connaughton from Durham Middle School. As Jerry joins us, we hear from Durham Principal Dr. Patricia Alford.
We call her our MVP because in any given day, she might be serving as a classroom teacher, a parapro, a homeroom teacher, nurse, mama. She really does it all, and she always has a great attitude. She jumps in anywhere she's needed. She goes the extra mile above and beyond all the time. You'll see her at evening events, weekend performances on her own time to support our kids. She just loves kids. She's got a heart of gold, and we are so fortunate to have her. She's one of a kind. Jerry Connaughton, congratulations. We are so proud of you.
In the high school category, our next winner has worked in the district for 18 years. She's accurate and efficient in record keeping. She's also excellent in her communicative outreach to students and staff. Her diligence in working with supportive parent volunteers has created a successful workplace and resource for the school. Her principal says she has a very strong work ethic, and it shows by her working extra hours with a smile on her face. Please join me in congratulating Alice Brown from Lassiter High School. Alice Brown. And we'll hear from Lassiter Principal Chris Ritchie.
She's does an exceptional job working at Lassiter. She is here every single day. She's very diligent, keeping accurate records of everything that our students do. So we're extremely proud of her. She is a great staff member. The staff knows that she's somebody that they can go to. She is a very humble person. She loves Lassiter. She's been a faculty member for a few years, and I know the faculty is very proud to have her.
Congratulations, Alice Brown. We're very proud of you for being High School Classified Employee of the Year.
Our final level winner represents the central office. An 18-year Cobb County School District employee, she receives, prepares, and records district deposits for all incoming revenues from federal, state, and local governments, as well as from school accounts and other outside sources. She has done an outstanding job this past year in working on historical files in the freezer. It's an old converted freezer. She has gone above and beyond on reviewing, filing, and removing no longer needed records in the record center. She's one of the reasons the health initiative has started in financial services. One of her colleagues says that she's been walking the track long before the yellow lines were installed. She's a motivating factor for everyone she comes in contact with to keep healthy. As in many cases for our district, she was one person inspired, her ideas were recommended, and the idea became a reality. Her supervisor says of her, she's always courteous and helpful while developing solutions for efficiency and savings and health. Please join me in congratulating Diana Cothran from Financial Services. Diana Cothran. Turner and Jan Hendricks.
She's always pleasant with her demeanor when she greets you. She's always eager to help all the central office staff with their accounting analysis when they don't understand their collections, because her job as the cash specialist is to make all the district's deposits at the central office.
I called her the box czar. She controlled how people, you know, she controlled the filing. The freezer area had become so disorganized, and she was so instrumental with others on the financial services team in cleaning up that area.
I believe that everyone would say that if they need any information, that she's the person they're going to pick up the phone and call.
Congratulations, Diana.
As an honoree, I hope you realize that this doesn't happen in many places across the country. I'm all over the country, and this is just a special time to say thank you and honor you for the efforts. We've got some more fun ahead, and we've got to a couple more addresses, but now is the time to eat. So enjoy lunch, and we'll be back in a few minutes.
Everybody in this room incorporates those that serve those that teach, including me, including executive cabinet, board members, etc., because we have two types of employees in our district, those that teach and those that serve those that teach. But as MDJ Shadi was asking me over there, he said, well, do you think, you know, that they feel kind of, you know, behind the scenes and everything? And I said, yeah, we do, because the teachers are the superstars, right? And it's kind of the analogy to, you know, the Braves. You probably know at least one name on the Braves 9 starters, probably a couple, maybe 3 or 4. You don't know the head grounds crew. You don't know the pitching coach's name. You probably don't know anybody that works in the front office. But everybody that performs those duties each and every day is a vitally important member of the team, number one, and number two, vitally important to the success of the organization. Whether it be the Braves or whether it be the Cobb County School District, every member of our team is vitally important to our success and plays an important role in our one mission, which is student success. You know, I use this example all the time, and it's absolutely true. We have over half of our students ride school bus each and every day. And so for those over 75,000 students, the first face they see of our organization is the bus driver. And I know we've got some bus drivers in here from transportation. And so if those students on that particular bus don't have a good experience with that bus driver, it just goes downhill from there. And then ultimately, they're the last face that they see of our organization. So vitally important to the success of our organization. But you know, as I was reading the comments on the screen that your employees and principals wrote, one of the common themes on a lot of the comments was goes above and beyond. And that's why you're in the room today. Because just like Teacher of the Year, where those teachers of the year are selected by their peers at the school, this is exactly the same. So your peers selected you to be the classified employee of the year for a reason. They recognize the part that you play at your school, at the central office, transportation, maintenance, public safety, technology. Every department that we have is vitally important to the full functioning of our organization. And granted, we exist to teach. That's why we exist. But coming from one who has always been on the side of doing things that my job incorporated supporting those in the classroom. I can say I appreciate what each of you do because I get it. I've been there, I've done that, and I have seen the differences between organizations, school districts, of when people truly believe that they're part of the team and function as a team. I've seen it the other way. And believe me when I say, it's not a bragging point for us to say some fictional, high lofty goal to reach. We do have the best school district in the country because of you. It's the people that make up our organization that allow our students to excel in ways that bring us as a school district, number one, notoriety, but most importantly, that success for them to go on. Because let's face it, there's not, and I'm going to steal this from David Chastain because it was a good example in one of his speeches. You know, the cell phone that we hold on our hip, the computers that we have, the TVs that we have now, I mean, good grief, we've got refrigerators that'll tell you what's in the refrigerator and when you need to get more milk. All of that has been brought about because a teacher made an impact on a student and then moved on to bigger and greater things. And obviously, our leadership depends on the graduates that we walk across the stage each and every year. So regardless of what position you play on our team, I want to say thank you, and I want to let you know that we truly believe that we are one team with one goal of student success. So I thank you and have a great day. And now I get to introduce, I think, Kent, Mark, what was his name? Ken Kington. Yeah, let's welcome him and he brings us back.
I've known Chris Ragsdale for several years now and am just so impressed because I don't know if you realize and how many of you have been here for several years, but Cobb County has always been good, but it has truly moved to what is great. And it's really because of what Mr. Ragsdale has done. Because if there's one quality you'll see, you can make a list. I'm sure he's got adversaries that'll give you a list of what he doesn't and what he's not. But what he is engaged. He is engaged in what's going on. And that's been the difference. The board is engaged. This lunch doesn't exist other places. And it's to say what you're important. The reason why you are honorees, the reason why we recognize you today is because you are engaged. And in our society, you got to determine where you're going to engage. My wife and I were at Chili's the other night, and we're just sitting at our table. At the next table, my wife goes to the restroom, and there's a couple. And I can tell from their conversation that they're newlyweds. And they're just going back and forth. And this conversational engagement, and just out of nowhere, the husband asked the wife, "What's wrong?" To which she said, if you're married, you know what she said. She said, "Nothing, yes." To which he engaged and he says, "Well, honey, I can tell something's wrong. Why don't you just tell me?" And I'm sitting here, I'm not eavesdropping. They're just right there. And she said, I just want you to want what I want. And I just, oh, man. I wanted so badly to lean over this guy and go, "It's a trap. Don't say anything." But he didn't know. He's like, "Well, what do you want?" And she said, "See, you don't understand." And he's like, "What do you mean I don't understand? You said you want me to want what you want. How do I know what you want if you don't tell me what you want?" She just folded around and she goes, "Never mind." And she's on the verge of tears. And it could not have been more perfect timing. The waiter came at that moment to their table and said, "You guys ready to order? Do you know what you want?" And I thought, you know what? There's a time to engage. And what you have done is you've engaged. I want to give you three engagements of why you are here and why you are successful. The first is you take initiative. You take initiative. Our society is full of people who can point out what's wrong. And you're even the ones, believe it or not, the ones that when something's wrong, they don't do something about it. They call you. You're the ones that are the doers. You're the ones that take initiative. And I'm not talking about brown nose, get recognition initiative. I'm talking about actually seeing something and doing something. You're the front line. You're not the ones asking for help or permission. You're the ones just doing it. I was on a flight. I fly all over the country, and I was on a flight in a 2-hour delay to take off. pilot finally came on, and he's just like, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be cruising at 30,000 feet. And it was a bunch of other useless information. Then he just said this. He says, if there's anything we can do to make your flight more enjoyable, just send word up to the flight deck. And I thought, he does not mean that. And I don't remember, but I just pulled out a pen and started doodling on a napkin. The lady next to me started dying laughing. And flight attendant came by. She goes, you are the only two happy people on this flight. What is so funny? And she said, look at his note. And I had just written down, dear captain, the following would make my flight more enjoyable. A foot massage would make my flight more enjoyable. B, a barrel roll. I've never done a barrel roll. I think that would make my flight more enjoyable. Or C, arrive on time would make my flight more enjoyable. The flight attendant grabbed the napkin and walked away with it, and I was just like, okay, whatever. And I thought she's going to show her friends. Well, at the end of the flight, she came back. We're on our final descent. She drops a note in my lap. And I'm like, what is this? I opened it. It was from the captain. He said, dear sir, would you like a left or right barrel roll? And see, there's this engagement of initiative, seeing what is there and doing something about it. I want to give you an example of the environment that you provide. It's not a teacher. They definitely teach. They do a phenomenal job. But the environment that you set is critical. And I want to give you a couple examples. At Pope High School, several years, almost 10 years ago now, I'll never forget reading this, because my daughter was going through cancer treatment at the time. She's doing fantastic now. But at Pope High School, there was a young man. He was a football player, done very well, was a prospect for some college scholarships. But after spring practice, his shoulder was not so great. Goes to the doctor that summer. Ends up he has a rare form of cancer, and the treatments go on. And he left school that spring, the strapping lineman athlete, and he came back 80 pounds lighter, with no hair. And he says, I didn't know what kids were going to think. But see, the environment that Cobb County Schools inspires, that first day, he said, kids didn't know what to think. He said, but the second day, I'll never forget. Because at Pope High School, 32 students went home that night, and they shaved their heads so that Matt Hobby would know, you're not doing this alone. We're with you. And what you do is you take the initiative to provide this environment where people realize this is not just a safe place, this is a great place where I can be what I was meant to be. You encourage that. Not only initiative, but there's another word I want to just share with you. The second way you engage, it's a C word, and the best way I can describe it is just that you care. And if I can describe it this way, 9 months ago, I went through one of the most traumatic events in my life. I'm actually not supposed to be here. Not just here, but anywhere. I had gone for some tests, and the doctor said, you're fine, and they did some more. And long story short, there was a small period of time where I'd worked out at the Y, and John Adams, we worked out at the same Y. I worked out there, drove my bike, rode home, went to lunch, and went and have a stress test. And they said, something's seriously wrong here. And within 30 hours from working out, I was on the table having emergency quadruple bypass open heart surgery 9 months ago. And that just kind of rocked my world. But in the midst of that, and some of you look a little concerned, let me spoil the ending. I made it, okay? So you can relax. But in the midst of that, how many of you, this is the first time I've ever had to be in a hospital. I'd visited the hospital, but I'd never been in the hospital. How many of you have ever been in the hospital overnight? Anybody here? Okay, several of you, okay. And then you'll understand why they said this, and I did not understand it, because they said, you know, after the surgery, you have got to rest. Now, the worst place on the planet to rest is in the hospital. Anybody have this experience? I ended up giving up the first night. At midnight, I gave up. From midnight to 7 o'clock, 14 people came into my room, and I'm not exaggerating. One woman came in to weigh me. I'm like, I'm not a newborn. I'm going to weigh the same in the morning. And so the next night, I'm exhausted at this point and frustrated and still recovering day one. And I'll never forget, because the nurses would come in very gratefully, and they do a great job of providing care. They do. At Kennestone, I'm very thankful, incredible thoracic surgery team, and they're great at providing care. But that night, I'll never forget it, because the nurse came in, and I know they have a list of what they have to do, and they check it off on the computer, and I know the last they're required to do is to ask you, is there anything else we can do for you? Is there anything you need? because every one of them asked it, and they check it off the list. That night, I think his name was Dave, came in. Dave, I think he's a former military guy because he's very to the point, no real personality. He goes, yeah, is there anything else you need? Is there anything we can do for you? I said, Dave, how'd you like to be my favorite nurse of all time? And he's like, okay. And I was like, all right. I said, he says, what do you need? I said, 2 hours. I want to be able to sleep for 2 hours without being interrupted. And he said, I said, can you make that happen? Can you get everybody who's got to do something to come in and just let me sleep for 2 hours? And he was like, sure. I'm like, okay. And sure enough, he rounded everybody up. They all came in. And after about 15 minutes of poking and prodding and test, he walked to the door and he goes, you want the lights on or off? And I was like, off would be fantastic. And he turned the lights off. 3 hours later, he came back. He said, hey, man, we got to do a couple quick tests. I got everybody lined up. Took 15 minutes, and he walks back to the door, and he goes, do you want the lights on or off? I said, off would be great. He turned them off. 3.5 hours later, he came back. He says, hey, we got to do some stuff. How'd you sleep? I'm like, dude, I feel like a different person. See, because here's what happened, and here's what you are. See, Dave went from providing care to caring. It is a small sound, but an amazing difference. And that's why you're here. You provide a great service. You do a great job. But the reason you're here is because you actually care. And I want to tell you another, just the final way. And if you want to do the acronym, I love what Chris said. It's not just important what you do. It's vital. It doesn't work without you. It's vital. And an initiative, I. C, care, and you. It is critical, this ICU, because the last is just simply understand. You understand what you're about. No, we're not the teachers, but without what you do, it doesn't happen. It doesn't work. It's understanding. It's understanding. I'll give you one amazing example. Last year, I want to just tell you one story of one student who was introduced to Cobb County. His name is Damien. Damien comes from a very dysfunctional situation. Damien has traveled his entire life to multiple states because his mother has just kind of drug him all over. He's never lived anywhere for more than 6 months. His mother's a drug user. She's gone from state to state, place to place. He's moved never more than 6 months, often less. He's left with total strangers, abandoned multiple times. He ended up in Georgia the last time when he was abandoned and ended up in foster care in Cobb County. He went to Cheatham Hill, and then he went to Fry. And in that time, I want you to imagine a student, a 10, 11-year-old, and what that would be like to be moved that often, what kind of student that would be. It'd be hard. You have no home support. You've got no support elsewhere. But see, at Cobb County, the environment you create is one of safety. And not just safety, but inspiration. And Damien went to school for a year. And at the end of this past year, after 1 year in Cobb County, Damien had straight A's and was in the top 20% on the Iowa skills testing. 1 year in Cobb County. And Damien, the reason I know that is Damien was my foster son, and we're in the process of adopting him right now. Because that's what you do. For me, it's personal. And I'm thankful to get to encourage you with that today. If I could wrap it with this, it would be simply the back during the beginning of the space program, NASA was charged with the opportunity and the challenge to get a man to the moon. And I love this example. A group of senators and congressmen went down to the main Kennedy Space Center, and they're doing a tour. And there's a gentleman who is a janitor. He is sweeping the floors, and there was a little bit of a lull before the next appointment, the next meeting. And a few of the senators were standing there next to this gentleman, and one of them asked him. He said, wow. He says, what do you do here? And the janitor looked at him with a straight face, with a full heart, and he said, we're putting a man on the moon. That's what we do here. And see, he may or may not have understood the question, but the answer is dead serious, right on the middle of the bullseye. What do you do here? Well, we assure student success. That's what we do here. It takes many forms, but thank you. Thank you for what you do. Keep doing that because you're the one. You're the one. See, everybody can look at it and say, well, I know that needs to be done. I know that should be done. I know there's a problem over here, but you're the ones doing it. And everybody else is standing around. I'll leave with this mental picture. It's one of my favorites. One Sunday, a buddy of mine asked me, what are you doing this afternoon? I said, nothing. He says, I'm going to the Falcons game. You want to go? I got an extra ticket. I'm like, yes. I'd never been to the Georgia Dome at that point. And we go, and we had great seats. We were in the fifth row from the roof. Okay, we were up there. And after the game, we had a great time. But after the game, you go down those huge people mover ramps that you spiral down till you have vertigo by the time you get to the bottom. And I went for the ramp, and he grabbed my arm. He says, hey, come here. And I'm like, hey, we got to go. And he's like, just trust me. We walked around a corner down a short hall to an express escalator. It went from the top level all the way to the street level. And it was like 100 yards long. It was amazing. It's like, oh, wow. And you can see the people walking while we're going down. I'm like, this is awesome. The only problem was halfway down, it stopped. Like, crud. But then we stood there. And we stood there. I can't see because hundreds of people are leaning over. I don't know why, because everybody's grumbling and complaining. I'm like, this is ridiculous. What is the problem? We stood there 2.5, almost 3 full minutes waiting on this escalator. Finally, a guy in the back, out of frustration, just screams at hundreds of people, walk! Just walk! And we all started walking down the escalator. I wish I could have seen the guy on the front. Oh, dang, and I was almost there, too. I hope they fix this soon. I got to get home. You know, the greatest part about that is every single person knew what to do. It took one person with the attitude that says, you either walk or get out of my way. And let me tell you, that's the reason why you're here and why we are honoring you today. Because you're the ones who see it and you walk. Keep walking. God bless you guys. John Adams, come up and wrap us up. Thank you.
I want to once again say thank you to Ken Kington. If you've ever talked in front of a large group, you know that it's difficult to be funny. And it's even harder to be funny and be clean. I've heard a lot of comedians in my day, and Ken manages to be clean and leaves you not feeling dirty. Sometimes you listen to some comedians and you'll laugh, but you're almost ashamed of yourself afterwards. And Ken, when you listen to him, you feel like you're a better person for having done it. So Ken, the world is a better place for having you in it. So thank you for doing this and for being you. And then certainly not least, but along similar lines, thank you all for what you do. You are our MVPs. You may not be on the front page, but you're on the front lines, and we appreciate everything you do. You do the real work of the district, and you are the people who really make this district work. So thank you for what you do. Drive safely and have a great day.